Hello, what's up? Welcome to another quick edit video. And for this image, I'm really excited since once more, this is an image with lots of post-processing involved. So if you're not into heavy photo manipulation, this video might be not for you, but feel free to stay. Let's go. So my goal for this image is to turn it into a very warm landscape image. First off, I want to change the profile to Adobe Landscape, which will just give me some more base saturation, as you can see, especially in the blue parts of the sky. I kind of want to get rid of most of those blue color tones. Therefore, I am changing the white balance temperature, and let's just turn it up. Somewhere around here looks pretty nice. You can see we still have a little bit of blue left in the sky, but all those clouds do come with a warmer color tone now. Alright, now let's also introduce some tint, but that should be fine. Next up, you can see looking at the histogram there is a lot of overexposure going on. In this case, if there's some overexposure, I don't really care. I think it's looking way more natural this way. Still, I want to fix that, and for this, let's bring down the highlights. That looks better for now. Of course, this area does look a bit ugly due to this change, but we will fix that later. Then let's fix the darker areas by bringing up the shadows a bit. And that just helps to restore detail from the dark parts. Now I think we do lack some contrast, so let's change that. Okay. Besides all those warm color tones, I also want to make this image look a little softer. And for that reason, as usual, I'm dropping the texture very carefully, as well as the clarity. Okay, and finally, let's boost the vibrance so we get some more colors in here. Nice. That's it for the base adjustments. Let's head over to the local adjustments. I'm starting with the gradiated filter as usual. Here, let's work on the sky first. You can see I have two different gradiated filters up here. One is basically for the clouds, while the other one is for the blue part of the sky. But let's first work on the clouds with this one. To make them pop out some more, I'm going to add a bit of contrast. Also, I don't really like the sharp look of those clouds, so I'm dropping the texture and thus just make them a little more fluffy. Nice, and finally let's add some temperature just to make the clouds a little warmer. Nice. Now let's work on the blue part of the sky, which I want to darken using this gradiated filter. And to darken something, I usually just drop the exposure. Of course, this will now also affect the clouds, which I don't want. In this case, we can scroll down in the gradient filter menu and just activate the color range mask. You can see this little eyedropper here. That means I just have picked up the blue color tone. So only those colors are affected by this gradiated filter. Nice, that's it for the sky. Let's work on the reflection in the foreground. Again, here I just want to add some contrast. I also can boost the clarity, which should work pretty good here. And again, to reduce the sharpness of the area, I'm dropping the texture. Alright, we could make it a little brighter by bringing up the whites. But that looks really good already. Now let's head over to the radial filters. And with those, I want to fix the bright area around the sun, making it look a bit better. So my intention here is to add some glow around this area. And that's basically done by adding some blacks. But I can also make use of negative dehaze, which works really good in this case. And this way we're probably going to overexpose this area again, but I don't care, as long as it looks good. Okay, now we might also introduce some more colors in here. So I'm clicking on this color field right there. And let's go with a nice warm color tone. This should look good. Now this area looks much better. Let's do the same thing in the reflection in the water. Bring down the dehaze. And let's increase the blacks. Alright, nice. Now on the right side, I don't really like this edge between the sky and the foreground. I want to add some kind of light bleed effect, which makes this edge a little softer. And again, I'm just adding a little bit of negative dehaze to do that. Alright, nice. And that's it for the local adjustments. Now let's do the color grading for this image. I'm starting in the color mixer tab. First off, I'd like to change the hue of a few color tones. That means let's bring down the orange hue and the yellow hue. Okay, nice. In the saturation tab, I slightly want to boost the oranges. And then let's reduce the greens a bit, as well as the blue tones. Okay, let's continue with the color grading. And here I want to do the split toning. For the highlights, of course, I want to go with a warm color tone since we are working on a sunset image. Maybe let's bring down the saturation a bit, but that looks good. Then for the midtones, I want to do the same thing with a warm color tone and a little less saturation. All right, then for the shadows, let's go with a cold color tone. And again, let's slightly bring down the saturation, and that's it for the split toning. Now the final part of the color grading is happening in the calibration tab. First off, I want to work on the blue primary hue a bit. Right now you can see the sky does have a little bit of a purple color cast, and I can just fix that by bringing down the blue primary hue. Alright, maybe let's boost the saturation as well. Nice. And then I think I want to boost the green primary hue. Okay, looks much better. Then let's go into the details tab and sharpen this image. Nice, and now finally we can finish the editing in Photoshop. Alright then, first I want to do some dodging, especially to the midtones. For this reason I'm going to apply a new layer, change the blending mode to overlay. For the dodging, I will be using the TK panel plugin. With this one, I can just create luminosity masks to, in this case, specifically target the midtones of the image by pressing this button. Here you can see the midtones layer mask, and on this layer, I'm using a white foreground color with the brush tool and just paint in a little more brightness. Alright, that's already enough. Maybe let's bring down the opacity of this layer. Perfect. Then I want to merge those two by selecting them and hitting Ctrl E. And next up, I think I already want to check out the Nick Collection plugin. Right here on the right side, you can see I already have a selection of a few filters I want to add on this image. So let's go through it one by one. With the polarization filter, I just add some more contrast, especially to the blue part of the sky, and overall just make the colors a little stronger. Next, I have applied the Pro contrast just to add a little more dynamic contrast. It's the most obvious in the foreground, I guess, where it makes the clouds a little brighter in the reflection. And finally, I went with the Skylight filter, which again just makes those warm sunset colors a little stronger. So let's apply it like this. I really like how this looks. I just think this area is a little too saturated. So I'm creating a layer mask. And with the foreground color set to black, I'm going to grab the brush tool and just paint over this area to fix the oversaturation. Nice. Then again, let's merge everything. At this point, I want to enhance the glow of this image a little more, so let's create a new layer and switch the blending mode to soft light. With the brush still selected, I'm going to pick up one of those warmer color tones by holding down Alt key and clicking in this area. Now let's change brush opacity a bit and paint in some more glow. You can see on the right side I'm going to make this light bleed effect a lot stronger by carefully brushing over this. And I also want to add it on the left side. Just like that. Alright, nice. And again, I'm merging those two layers. And one final thing I want to do, since I don't like how those clouds look, I want to add some motion blur to them. I'm selecting the quick selection tool right there and just make a rough selection over the sky. Of course, now we have also selected parts of the tree. I'm going to simply deselect them by holding down the Alt key and brushing over those tree branches. We really don't need a perfect selection here. Alright, and now to get the sky separated, I'm going to hit Ctrl C to copy it and right away paste it as a new layer. So here we have the sky layer. And on this layer, I'm simply going to filter, blur, motion blur, and just add some subtle motion blur. Just like that. Okay, now you can see on the tree we do have some strange looking motion blur in there as well. That's not a big deal. I'm simply adding a layer mask right there. And let's grab a black brush again and just brush over this area. Okay, of course we need to do the same thing on the reflection. So again, use the quick selection tool to make a rough selection right there. Cut out the tree roughly. Then Ctrl C and Ctrl V to copy this layer. And just apply the motion blur once more. And again, create a layer mask and mask out the area around the tree. And that's it. As I said in the intro, that's a very heavy manipulated image. I still like the post-processing of it and how it looks right now. So I hope this was an interesting video. If you have any questions about the editing, let me know in the comments. And thank you so much for watching this video.